Leeds United, the visitors to Ellen Road today. Manchester United playing in the dark shirt. A big crowd here on a damp, cold day. The crowd all set to see some splendid football between two of the leading sides in the land. Leeds United, who've got a home win and an away defeat against Manchester United, who play in the dark shirt. And now, if we could have a look at the two teams, Leeds United first. They've got a lot of injuries. Jackie Charlton's out, and so too is Bobby Collins. They're the two main ones, but they've got four of their most experienced players injured, and you'll see they're playing a 4-3-3 system. Gray, the 18-year-old midfield player, he scored on his debut last season. So Leeds United having to play a very young, very inexperienced team today. But Manchester United, they've not had to make any changes because of injury, but you'll notice that Pat Creran still can't get back into the team. Fitzpatrick will be playing at number four midfield player with Bobby Charlton. And there's number eight, Dennis Law, and number nine, Bobby Charlton, who will not be marked by his brother in this match. And so, those are the two teams. The weather, not particularly magnificent, but the crowd, extraordinarily good. A packed house for what should be a stirring game of football before a crowd of, I should say, well over 40,000 people. Manchester United then to kick off. And it's highly important day as we see between two of England's leading teams. The referee, Mr. Kevin Harley of Billingham, is checking his watches. And although Manchester United lining up in the old-fashioned way with Bobby Charlton in the centre forward position, I doubt whether we're going to see him there straight after he's kicked off. So Manchester United starts this match, and Bobby Charlton does not move forward as one would expect an old-fashioned centre forward to do. But there's nothing old-fashioned about Bobby Charlton. Now here's Johnny Giles, a former Manchester United player and one of the best midfield players in the game today. Doesn't usually pass the ball like that. Ground very wet on top. We've had quite a lot of rain this morning. It's Charlton. Third. It's Patrick. That was a nasty one coming through a crowd of players. Notice it's straight. The Welsh international goalkeeper for Leeds United, wearing gloves, the ball extremely slippery. Gaskell at the other end is wearing gloves as well. Lorimore, one of the many promising Leeds youngsters. Law, and nobody coming up on his left to support him. Bell, usually a wing fullback, now playing centre back today because Jackie Charlton, one of the four Leeds United star players, injured. The others are of Grady, Peacock, and Collins. Bobby Charlton. Here's the goal kick. Mr. Harley had a look at him. You'll notice number three, who's left wing fullback, is now playing right back for Leeds. They've switched their wing fullbacks. Instead of reading Rini and Cooper, they're now Cooper and Rini. Styles. For England, remember, he was a midfield player. For Manchester United, he's a fullback. Hunter. Oh, a bad one. The hair to Law. Played Bell now to Johansson. Fitzpatrick take the throw for Manchester. Charlton. The fellow in front of him is Madeley. Now Lorimer having come back. There's a midfield man for Leeds. Lorimer playing more in the midfield than Gray at the moment. Archer. Johansson. This is Giles. A goal! Scored by Medley. And there's Medley, number 9, up in the attack this week. Last week, he was back in the fullback line. But at least he puts Leeds 1-0 in the lead. Team then Gaskell is unsighted. But anyway, Leeds lead 1-0. 5 minutes gone. Ah, Johnny Giles. Giles to take the corner, take the free kick for no Hunter. Now Brennan, to head. And listen to these Leeds United supporters. Oh, nice bit of play by Charlton to Brennan. Third. Hunter to Giles. Leeds moving very smoothly, very well. Across the south. Oh, Stiles and Best not making up their minds then. Bremner to Johansson. One could have been an after one, it was deflected. Law, there's Connelly way out on the left. Moves Law. Well, that was nearly the goal of all time. Dennis Law, the man sitting on his backside, just trying to flick it in. Best, the man who got the first goal of the season. Bremner for Leeds. Man to watch for when Leeds attack is their number 2, Rini. He's streaking forward with the attack. Manchester's throw. Here's Greeny, leaving it for Giles. Giles getting through a tremendous amount of work. No doubt about it, Leeds have started off at a cracking pace. You'd never think that four of their most experienced players were out of the side. To the others, seem to be wrong-footed. Nevertheless, Paul Madeley making a very good leader of the Leeds United attack. Centre half, both teams appealing, and the linesman gives a goal kick. The referee has given a corner, saying that Brennan kicked his foot out and just took the ball over the line. Johansson going to take the corner for Leeds. Fitzpatrick limping a bit, seems seriously perturbed. And he's fouled by Madeley. Free kick to Manchester United being taken by Fox. Kennelly trying his luck on this side of the field, but no more luck than he had on the far side. Lead throw. Into a bad pass. And Madeley moving in. That one was well taken by Gaskell. Madeley having a fine game leading this Leeds attack. Comes Kennelly. Now Dunn. Good anticipation by Sprague. He was down at Law's feet before the ball arrived. Madeley in there. Nice. Johansson. Oh, it's a goal scored by Leeds. That has been on throughout the whole of the match. That, I would say, a great goal by Leeds. Great, because they thought it out so well. Manchester United expected the high one for Madeley. They covered that extraordinarily well. And then Reaney, as he has done so often in this match, made about 20 yards and got himself in position. So, a back come up from defence to put Leeds 2-0 in the lead. That's heard Charlton. Number two, Shay Brennan. He was born in Manchester, but he has an international cap for the Republic of Ireland under the rule which states that if he's not wanted by the country in which he was born, he can, of course, play for the country of his father's birth. Before Bremner, skipper of Leeds United. Lorimer, expert at floating those long ones for Madeley, who's so dynamic in the air, was fouled then by Funks. So almost on half time, a free kick to Leeds United. Two midfield masters, Bremner on the right, there, right ahead one, then Giles take it, the free kick. Johansson. Laugh about it. Johansson to Madeley. Fox. Fox, a great servant for Manchester United. Bremner, although Rini was moving up, but best anticipated it. This is Charlton. There he goes, Dunn down the left. Seemed to be a little bit of a misunderstanding then between Sprake and Cooper. He's getting away with it. Young Graham Styles. Madeley back to Giles. Oh, well, that fell to Norman Hunter's right foot, which is nothing like as lethal as his left. Can be a bit confusing in this match. The Giles and the Styles. There's the tall fella Norman Hunter moving back. Mind you, Giles and Styles were more confusing when they were on the same team for Manchester United. And there goes the whistle for half-time. Leeds United, deservedly, 2-0 in the lead.
Well, that's just the sort of football we'd expect from teams the caliber of Leeds United and Manchester United, and no doubt at all that Leeds United have been the better side. I like the way they've been playing the ball down the middle to Madeley, this most versatile young player who's been getting nearly every one of them in the air, and that's saying something against a man like Bill Foulkes. And Leeds have been carving up far more dangerous situations than Manchester United have. And, of course, the way Rini came up to get that second goal shows how dangerous it can be when you have your defenders overlapping as he did. And so, Leeds United in a strong position, 2-0 in the lead, so should be heading for their second successive win.
Leading 2-0. Leeds United stopped the second half. Madeley and Rini the scorers. The Leeds United must feel pretty confident of picking up 2 points from this match. And away go Leeds United. Start the second half, 2-0 up. And perhaps a measure of Leeds superiority can be gained from the fact that Matt Busby has now left his seat in the director's box and has gone down to sit on the trainer's bench. Matt Busby, the Manchester United manager. Don Revie, the Leeds manager, always sits on the trainer's bench. Young Gray is slinging that one in. Nine Charlton, notice Bremner close to him. Bremner is number four. Is Reaney a score of one of the goals? Oh, and that best hurt. Bremner coming through. And a chance now. A fine save from Gray. Fine save by Gaskell from Gray. There's Best, number seven. Oh, he had a cartilage operation during the off-season. Bremner. Lovely bit of work by Giles. Back to Bell. Leeds play some beautiful football. Bell looks if he's played centre-back all his life. Cooper. Bremner to Lorimer. So far, fortunately, the rain has kept off during the match. Had it this morning and before the kickoff. Now it's Best for Manchester United. Madeley. Madeley to Gray. Here's Madeley. Played a splendid game. With Giles, and there's Hunter going away on his left. Lorimer. Crowd shouting, go on, is very well, but couldn't quite work out what he should do. Bremner to Lorimer. There's Madeley, Gray. Manchester United defence having to pull out all the stops. I think I spoke too soon. I said the rain had kept off during the match, and it's just starting to come down now. Oh, Fouts caught in trouble. Now it's Johansson. Play on, the referee playing the advantage rule then, even though Johansson was fouled. Oh, good anticipation by Bremner to snatch up that throw. Corner, yes, corner two. Leeds United, and once again Manchester United in a whole heap of trouble. Giles to take the corner for Leeds. Here's Charlton. Leeds head back into their defensive positions to cover all avenues to their goal. Law to Charlton. That is the first sort of shot that's really raised the hopes of the Manchester supporters. Lorimer. one off for Hunter. Not a good centre by Hunter. He should have been pulled back a little bit more for Medley. Number 8 is Law. Number 5, William Bell. Medley in the second bit again. Fitzpatrick to her, to Kennelly. Charlton and Bell. Desperation tackle. Now Kennelly, number 11. Kennelly trying to tee it up the Charlton. Giles, man of supreme anticipation, calmness, fine, quick footballing brain. A straight, one of the best goalkeepers there are. Done leaving it for number 9, Charlton. Fitzpatrick, that's best on his right, and here's her. Best moving forward, he's free at the moment. There's Best, a good move. And a fine goal. A fine goal. 13 minutes of the second half goal. Second half round. There's the scorer, George Best. And a good lesson by Best in how to run off the ball. He ran when Heard was in possession. Heard just waited long enough to push that pass through. There's Heard just on the left. And Manchester United got a goal that was well thought out and well executed. Once again, it's been proved that when you haven't got the ball, you should be running to get into position so you can receive it. United supporters gone mad with joy now, because suddenly it didn't look as if they were going to get a goal. Now one flash of real vintage Manchester United football brought them the goal. So the singing and counter-singing of when the reds and when the whites go marching in. You seem to have heard that before somewhere. And a free kick to Manchester, foul on Law by Bell. Charlton takes the free kick. It's going to be teed up for him. Up goes Law. Oh, Dennis Law almost caught Leeds napping. Then there's Law right in the centre of the picture. Quarter of an hour of the second half gone. And coming back to fight. And now breaking away from defense, South African wing Gray. Fine bit of work by this young Scottish inside forward. Number 3 is Cooper. Ion, not over the line. The whole of the ball's got to cross the line before it's out of play. 20 minutes of the second half gone. 2-1, Leeds United in the lead. Manchester United on the attack. Charlton, number 9. Foul, I think, by Head on Giles. Yes, free kick to Leeds. This is Giles. Mainly. Lorimer. Got Bremner inside in square, but covered now, so Cooper moves up. Now Bremner's free. Herder, that's Law going away on the right. Connelly. Manchester got 5 men up in attack now. Charlton, we may well see a blinder from him. Lorimer, a beautiful bit of football to Rini, and now to Gray. This is Giles, and there's Hunter going down on the left. Now those are two near the goalkeeper. There's not much chance of a forward getting up to them. Fitzpatrick, a lot of room in which to work. Leeds playing it coolly out of defence. This is Giles. Giles with quick acceleration. Lovely! Some stirring stuff in this match. There's Norman Hunter. Covered every blade of grass on the pitch. Oh, well done, Gray. Now Lorimer. All he could do quickly. A goal kick. Quick thinking by these youngsters, Gray, and then Lorimer, the man who put it over the top. There's Gray, number 8. Brennan to Herd. Oh, good move to Kennelly. And it's a goal now. What the line by Rini. Leeds are making life difficult for themselves now. Their defence can't make one mistake, otherwise they'll be level. Manchester United will be level. And yet, with the amount of possession they've had, their forwards should have had more than 2 goals. It's Kennelly. Now Charlton. I've not seen much of Leeds for the last few minutes as an attacking force. But a wee bit anxious for that situation to change. Well played, Red. Madeley. Up to number 7, Lorimer. Rini's gone up now, number 2. Well, the linesman, having sorted that lot out, says corner. Can you lip read? Otherwise, you'll know exactly what Mr. Norbert Stiles says. After that speech by Nobby Stiles, it's a corner for Leeds. Lorimer. A beautiful goal. Peter Lorimer, who with 11 minutes to go makes it Leeds 3, Manchester United 1. The Manchester players still very annoyed that a corner was given, but nevertheless it was a corner. When it was given, Leeds took it extraordinarily well, very accurate, sensible pass to Lorimer, who hanging on the edge of the area. Good thoughtful goal. Free kick to Leeds for offside. That third goal has come at a great psychological moment, because it looked as if Manchester United were getting on top and could well have snatched a point. But now the pressure lifted from Leeds a wee bit. They lead 3-1. 10 minutes left. The state of affairs, a 3-1 lead, bringing forth the song of "We Shall Not Be Moved" from the Leeds United fans. Well, that was not a player. Way goes best. Three is done. Lorimer chasing him. Cooper going in. Down goes Charlton. Free kick to Manchester United. Charlton in a wee bit of pain. I think the trainer coming on to him. No. The referee says, no trainer. Nevertheless, the trainer's on. Here's Jackie Crumpton. Here's Bobby Charlton, still pinching the pain. He gets the ball from Best. And young Gray showing commendable coolness. Gray out of Giles. Gray at full speed going down the middle. There he is. Boy, he's got a footballing brain. Don Reeve told me before the match, if he's really on his game, he can turn it on. Well, I wouldn't argue with that assessment of him. Johansson. Free kick to Manchester United. Giles is going to take this free kick. Songs of victory is swelling up from the Leeds United fans now. The right scars being waved in triumph. Giles takes the free kick. Head. Mainly, very the game of his life. Splendid match he's had. Brennan forward to Fitzpatrick. A law. The build up, Manchester United. Now all too slow. They had the moment when they were getting on top of this match. Then came that third goal, which is knocked United, Manchester United that is, down to the canvas again. Cooper. Leeds can play close, keep possession now if they want. Cooper looks if he's having a spot of trouble with cramp. There's Cooper. This is Madeley. Giles caught by the late over-the-wall tackle by Best Cricket to Leeds. There's Georgie Best, Manchester United Irish international, great player. Les Cocker, the Leeds United trainer, one of the two trainers with the England World Cup squad, trying to get the action back into Cooper's muscles. It appears to have succeeded. And we go back to the free kick being taken now by Giles. Lorimer. Best having to come deep, far into the defensive network to help his side. The minutes tick away, about three left. Not counting into retire. Good throw, sir. Yes, it's over the line. Goal kick to Manchester United. Brennan. Not much time left for Manchester United now. Looks as if they're facing their first defeat of the season. Well, fortune always favors the brave. Greeny getting it out now to Giles. Number nine. Madeley going across close to him. Giles good enough to keep possession until somebody's in position. Now it's Bremner. Giles never stops working, never stops moving. Cooper. Oh, well played, Cooper. Cramp and all. Oh, that was something out of the blue. Johansson. Best, the barber's nightmare with those flowing locks of his. The style. Comes Fox. It's a last despairing effort by Manchester United now. But there's nobody up for Leeds. And Cooper's rolling in agony with cramp in his own penalty area. There are two Leeds men down. But the game goes on. This is Giles. Up comes Bremner. And the whistle is gone. As trainers are called on, there's Cooper. Cram having hit him again. Oh. And And Les Cocker is not trying to pull it off. The referee now says, get Hunter off the pitch. Anyway, Hunter's on his feet. There are only seconds left for play. Leeds United lead 3-1. This is Bremner. And the whistle goes for the end of the match. Leeds United have beaten Manchester United after a splendid game of football.